quality of the air we breathe affects our health. Exposure to high levels of air pollutants has been associated with cardiovascular and respiratory diseases. Levels of some kinds of air pollution, like soot, have come down a lot over the years as a result of environmental protection policies. But levels of other pollutants, like ozone, have not come down as much. It's also been noticed that lung diseases associated with smoking, like emphysema, are occurring in people who don't smoke. Here in the U.S., researchers have been working to understand the relationship of air pollution to health outcomes, including lung health and emphysema. Emphysema is destruction of the air sacs in the lung, most often caused by smoking. The amount of lung affected by emphysema can be measured on a CT scan and is associated with lung function impairment. This brings us to a study published in the current issue of JAMA. Researchers used data from MESA, a community-based cohort study. Participants between the ages of 45 and 84 were recruited starting in 2000 and followed up through 2018. These participants resided in six cities throughout the U.S. Chicago, Winston-Salem, Los Angeles, Baltimore, St. Paul, and New York. All participants had a baseline cardiac CT scan, and most had at least one, if not several, follow-up scans. Exposures to four pollutants, ozone, fine particulate matter, oxides of nitrogen, and black carbon, were estimated over the follow-up period using EPA data to calculate annual mean concentrations for each pollutant correlated with each participant's home address. Using CT scans, the researchers measured change in percent of the lung affected by emphysema up to 5 times per participant. They also performed spirometry up to 3 times on each participant to evaluate their lung function. Just over 7,000 participants were followed for a median 10 years. One-third to one-half of them never smoked. Median percent emphysema was 3% at baseline and increased a mean 0.58% per 10 years. The authors found a statistically significant association between baseline ambient concentrations of ozone, fine particulate matter, oxides of nitrogen, and black carbon, and increases in progression of percent emphysema over those 10 years. What about exposure to pollution over time? There, the authors found statistically significant associations between increases in oxides of nitrogen and ozone and progression in percent emphysema. A 3 parts per billion higher long-term mean ozone exposure over follow-up was associated with an increase in progression of percent emphysema over 10 years, equal to the association between 29 pack years of smoking and emphysema progression. In other words, if the ambient ozone level was 3 parts per billion higher over 10 years where you live compared to another location, that's roughly the equivalent of smoking a pack of cigarettes a day for 29 years. And as we see in Figure 2A, ozone levels in some major U.S. cities are increasing by that amount. The good news is that during the observation period of this study, the long-term average concentrations of fine particulate matter and oxides of nitrogen decreased, as shown in these two figures. What about lung function? Ozone concentrations at baseline and over follow-up were statistically significantly associated with a faster decline in FEV in the first second, or FEV1, which is a standard measure of lung function. The authors conclude that long-term exposure to ambient air pollution is significantly associated with increased emphysema-like changes seen on CT scans, as well as with declines in lung function. To read the study, click the link in the description.